Hello everyone, I hope this video finds you in very good health. Today's article has been taken from the Economic Times. The title of this article is Don't Prefix an Arbitrary Fiscal Cap. Arbitrary is something that is based on random decisions, random choices, okay, on personal whim. Fiscal is something that is related to government finances. Cap is basically a limit. Prefix is something that is fixed in advance. So the editor, via the title of this article, is trying to suggest, to advise the government, that the government should not prefix any random fiscal limit. It has been reported that the government would limit its fiscal deficit to 5.5% of GDP and contain the size of the stimulus it offers to the economy to a size that fits in with that target. Aisa pata chala hai, that the government will or is going to fix the fiscal deficit target to 5.5% of GDP. Okay? And that whatever stimulus that it offers to the economy will be according to that 5.5% fiscal deficit target. What fiscal deficit is in the first place? Fiscal deficit is basically the difference between the total income and the total expenditure of the government. In this case, since income is less and expenditure is more, it's a deficit. And since it is related to government finances or the government revenue or the government income and government expenditure, it is called fiscal, hence the term fiscal deficit. Now 5.5% of GDP to be the fiscal deficit is a rather rough and small figure compared to the earlier targets, something around 3.5 or 3% that you were targeting earlier. 2.5, 3.5 were in the news some months ago. So this is not really advised by the editor of this article. We suggest that the government leave the fiscal deficit target open-ended for the time being. The editor is saying that there shouldn't be any focus on fiscal deficit. Rather, the focus should be on providing stimulus and helping the economy to, you know, stand again. Okay? The economy will take time to regain its mojo. Mojo is a magical charm. So the magical charm with which the economy was working or performing earlier, given the current state of crisis that the country or the globe is going through, the economy will take time to regain its mojo. More than one round of stimulus spending might be warranted or might be needed. In which case, it makes no sense for the government to tie its hand in advance by pre-committing itself to a relatively low level of the fiscal deficit. So, as a 3.5 se jump karke 5.5% ya 3% se jump karke 5.5% ka fiscal target set karke koi bada achievement nahi hone wala hai. Rather, you should be helping the economy, giving a helping hand to the economy by providing fiscal stimulus and letting production increase to unprecedented levels post this pandemic situation. All right, so the government should not tie its hand in advance. Pehle se hi khud pe limit na laga lein ki bhai 5.5% of GDP hi hum stimulus mein de sakte hain, at maximum usse zyada nahi de sakte. What if there is more requirement? In that case, how will you change your commitments then? So the government should not do this. Today's world is very different from the conventional world, whose macroeconomic framework underpins the economic models of the rating agencies, which misfire far too consistently in the face of crisis at a firm level or the level of the economy to inspire fear of their wrath. Long sentence. Pehle in words ko samajh jaye. Underpin is to make something strong from beneath, from the fundamentals, from the basics. Theek hai? To strengthen something. Wrath is extreme anger. अब यहाँ पर रेटिंग एजेंसीज की बात हो रही है, इकोनॉमिक मॉडल्स की बात हो रही है, मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक फ्रेमवर्क की बात हो रही है, कन्वेंशनल वर्ल्ड की बात हो रही है. तो पहला स्टेटमेंट का पहला जो हिस्सा है, टुडेज वर्ल्ड इज़ वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द कन्वेंशनल वर्ल्ड, मीन्स द मॉडर्न इकोनॉमी इज़ वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द कन्वेंशनल इकोनॉमी. कन्वेंशनल इकोनॉमी वॉज वेयर वेरी कन्वेंशनल इकोनॉमिक्स वॉज प्रैक्टिस्ड. मॉडर्न इकोनॉमी इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दैट. ठीक है, modern economic framework, whose macroeconomic framework, the framework of the modern, the macroeconomic framework of the modern economy underpins the economic models of the rating agencies. Now, rating agencies like CRISIL etc. that you know of, these rating agencies, how do they judge, how do they find out whether an economy is going to grow or falter in the coming times? They have an economic model of their own. They see that there is a particular way in which an economy grows, and if there is any country that is conforming to the standards of that economic model, it is fine to go with. Otherwise, it is going to falter. That is how these rating agencies calculate whether any country is going to grow or not. ठीक है, and these calculations misfire far too consistently. ठीक है, consistently लगातार misfire होता है, miscalculations होते रहते हैं, जिसकी especially at the times of crisis. ठीक है, और ये miscalculations दोनों level पे होते हैं, firm level पे भी, मतलब इन rating agencies के level पे भी, and also when these economic models are practiced at the national economic level, so at the level of the economy also. So these miscalculations inspire fear of their wrath. अब wrath इसलिए use हुआ है, या extreme anger इसलिए use हुआ है यहाँ पे, क्योंकि when any country does not conform to the economic, to the standards of the economic models of these rating agencies, what they do is they have a list of the best and the worst performing economies. They downgrade the ratings of those countries, which leads to even further installation of fear in the market, in the minds of the buyers and sellers of that market, of that economy. It is the wrath of these rating agencies, it is the extreme anger of these rating agencies that leads to such crisis, the crisis, and that leads to the installation of fear in the minds of the market, of the buyers and sellers, and the buyers are not ready to buy, sellers are not able to sell, and that crisis ensues. So a large part of the liquidity created to cushion economies from the Great Recession following the global financial crisis still sloshes around the global financial markets, depressing bond yields and elevating equity prices. Great Recession hua tha, to uske baad economies ne लिक्विडिटी अरेंजमेंट्स किए थे ताकि ज़्यादा पैसे मार्केट में फ्लो कर सके. ऑल दोज लिक्विडिटी इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स दैट वर यूज, लिक्विडिटी कुशन्स जिनको कहा जाता है, दे कैन स्टिल बी सीन हेयर एंड देयर अपियरिंग हेयर एंड देयर इन द ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल मार्केट. इसका मतलब है कि वेर एवर दीज लिक्विडिटी कुशन्स अपियर और आर सीन, इट मीन्स दैट समथिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन और समथिंग बैड हैज़ ऑलरेडी हैपन्ड इकोनॉमिकली ओवर दीज प्लेसेस. That leads to fear in the minds of investors and buyers in such places, and that leads to depression of bond yields or your lessening of the or decreasing of the profits from bonds and elevating equity prices, increasing equity prices, share prices. The pandemic has induced yet more liquidity creation in the US, Europe and Japan. Seen currently, due to this pandemic and the resultant economic crisis, places like the US, Europe and Japan, they have made liquidity arrangements. They have put in liquidity injections into their economy in the form of stimulus, in the form of various regulations by the ease of regulation by the central banks and various other instruments. So liquidity has been created. All that liquidity has to wash up somewhere where the prospects of a decent economic return are available. Now, whatever liquidity has been created in these places, they are ready to invest somewhere. Okay? Where will they invest? Any American or any European or any Japanese investor would like to invest that liquidity that he has got from the government at a place where there will be a decent economic return. India happens to be that place, provided the government of India acts with confidence, thinks big and acts bold. India must tap global capital both for its rupee loans and for a foreign currency bond offering. Okay? So two terms have been stated in this statement, rupee loans and foreign currency bond offering. Pehle in dono ko samajh lete hain. Rupee loans here refers to the rupee term loans. Now rupee term loans provide a medium for long-term financial assistance for setting up of new projects, their expansion, diversification or modernization in various manufacturing or services sector. ठीक है, domestic currency में अगर कोई आप loan दे रहे हैं, that is rupee term loan. Foreign currency bond offering here refers to the foreign currency convertible bonds or FCCBs which are issued in foreign currency to raise money in foreign currency. ठीक है, so India must tap or must seize the opportunity to capture the global capital via these two instruments. Foreign loans can be raised by a special vehicle guaranteed by the government, and only a fraction of the resultant contingent liability would show up as fiscal deficit. Let's understand contingent liability first. Given the pandemic and the resultant economic crisis, whatever is being done currently, whatever economic decisions or fiscal decisions are being taken, or whatever loans are being taken, whatever cash or resources are being transferred from one account to another, are in the face of an emergency. Hence the word contingent. ठीक है, कभी भी इमरजेंसी के लिए अगर कोई चीज़ यूज़ हो रही है तो उसको कंटिंजेंट कहा जाता है. लायबिलिटी एज वी डिस्कस्ड इन द फ्यू वीडियोस अर्लियर मींस लीगल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. नाउ इफ द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम समवेयर, इफ द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम द RBI, इफ द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम ADB और एनी सच ग्लोबल बैंक, वर्ल्ड बैंक एटसेट्रा, और द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम एनी अदर कंट्री, इट हैज़ अ लीगल लायबिलिटी और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू पे बैक दैट लोन. ठीक है, सो whatever loans you are taking is a liability, and that will eventually show up in the fiscal deficit, in the account where your income and expenditure will be matched. Theek hai, so what the editor is suggesting is that foreign loans, whatever foreign loans the government of India takes, should be guaranteed by the government, should be guaranteed, as in there should be guarantee that they will repay that loan in the given time. What will happen is that after all that is been done, after you have tapped global capital in the form of rupee loans and foreign currency bond offerings, and you have taken foreign loans with a guarantee, only a very tiny fraction, only a very small fraction of the entire liability that you owe to the world at this time will show up in the fiscal deficit. Only a small fraction of that responsibility of that entire loan will show up in the fiscal deficit, because when you are capturing or seizing these opportunities, what you will do indirectly is that you will increase the confidence of the market, of the economy in India. And that will lead to more production. More production will give you more income. More production will give you the capacity to pay back those loans quite easily, and you will not have to show them in the fiscal chart, or the fiscal deficit, or the fiscal surplus, or the fiscal calculations. So that will be the result of such steps. At a time when the private sector fights for survival, large investment by the public sector will not crowd out private investment. Rather, it would induce private investment. ठीक है? ये लिखा हुआ है कि ऐसे समय में जब private sector बहुत ज़्यादा struggle कर रहा है और public sector उसके investment बहुत ज़्यादा हो रहा है, इस केस में कल को जाकर जब इकोनॉमी रीस्टार्ट होगी, फिर से सब कुछ काम शुरू हो जाएगा, तो पब्लिक सेक्टर प्राइवेट इन्वेस्टमेंट को क्राउड आउट कर दे, दैट वोंट हैपन. इनफैक्ट इसका उल्टा होगा. इट विल इंड्यूस मोर प्राइवेट इन्वेस्टमेंट, इट विल इंस्पायर मोर प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूशंस टू इन्वेस्ट मोर. व्हाई? बिकॉज इफ देयर इज पब्लिक सेक्टर इन्वेस्टमेंट, इट मींस देयर इज मोर रिलायबिलिटी, दैट देयर विल बी मोर fixed amount, or there will be more fixed capital formation, so that will obviously attract private investment. ठीक है, there is little fear of inflation in the short run thanks to deflationary pressures and depressed commodity prices. Inflation का डर नहीं है, at least in the short run. Why? Because there are two things at play. One is deflationary pressure, second is depressed commodity price. Now deflationary pressure को ऐसे समझें कि when price falls and the consumer expects it to fall even more, so he'll restrict his spending. In that case, he'll wait for the commodity to reach at a rock bottom price, and only then will they buy. So there is fall in price, there is reduction in demand, there is a further fall in price, and this cycle keeps on going. That is a deflationary pressure tactic. ठीक है, at the same time commodity prices जो है बहुत घटे हुए हैं, raw materials के prices बहुत घटे हुए हैं, depressed हैं. Due to these two factors, inflation is not going to increase in the short run. In the absence of a significant state-funded or state-enabled stimulus, the economy would tank. Agar koi state-funded or state-enabled stimulus nahi milta hai, to economy would fail completely, and that too at a very great financial cost. It is more than likely दैट आरबीआई वुड नीड टू मोनेटाइज अ पार्ट ऑफ द डेफिसिट टू. आपको फिस्कल डेफिसिट को और भी कम करना होगा तो आरबीआई विल हैव टू स्टेप इन एंड विल हैव टू मोनेटाइज इट, विल हैव टू गिव सम मनी सो दैट यू कैन कवर सम ऑफ द डेफिसिट एंड कीप द फिस्कल डेफिसिट टू अ लोअर रेंज. सो दिस इज वॉट टूडेज आर्टिकल वॉज अबाउट. इट टॉक्ड अबाउट हाउ फिक्सिंग अ फिस्कल डेफिसिट टारगेट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड हाउ giving out a fiscal stimulus package in phases or in a number of times is more important than doing that, and how the global scenario of liquidity injection can be used to the benefit of the Indian economy, what the government should be doing and what it should not be doing. All the do's and don'ts have been suggested in this article. I will put up some questions in the description box so that you can answer them and get a clearer understanding into this topic. So thank you for watching. Stay in and stay safe. This is me signing off for today.